Southern Colorado is experiencing a reminder that fires, as we all know, don't just happen in the summer. And there were a few that popped up over the weekend.
And KRDO News Channel 13's Jay Polk joins us live on the weather deck, finding out how this is all possible.
It's a wonderful evening out here on our weather deck. Grill around the station earlier on this afternoon, couldn't really find one, but of course a grill is one of those things that does produce fire, and firefighters wanted to remind us that all this nice weather that we're seeing does have a downside.
This is Ute Valley Park in northwestern Colorado Spring. It's serene, usually windy, right now at least, very dry. It's also near the site of one of the worst fires in Colorado history, Waldo Canyon.
I took over a section, the southern section of Mountain Shadows, neighborhood.
It was only a couple of weeks ago that we saw snow around the area. You also know that we saw grass fires last weekend. It doesn't seem to add up. But if you work here, it makes perfect sense. Grasses can dry very quickly in our area with low relative humidity.
An hour of some warmer temperatures, direct sunlight, maybe a little wind, they'll be ready to burn.
There's also plenty of sunshine and the occasional warm spell. But it doesn't take record heat to get high fire danger.
Fuel moisture determines primarily what the fire danger is going to be.
Another factor that's important is something known as fuel load.
It's the density of the trees and the brush, the grass that's in an area.
You probably know the signs that point to a higher than normal fire danger. Determining what makes this sign move is the stuff of science, but it doesn't take an advanced degree to figure out how to stay safe.
Just be careful with the fire if you're having a barbecue or whatever you may be doing out there.
So that we can all enjoy nature this season.
And that was Jay Polk reporting. Now, as you remember, Rachel told us, you know, another warm day today. But while most wildland fires are caused naturally, Captain Brees says that one of the largest fires in what is now the Broadmoor Bluffs neighborhood was actually in January in 1950.
Yeah, just another reminder that wildfires can happen at any time, so be very careful.
Well,